At the beginning of the 2000s, reality shows were huge. And while some have come and gone, and in some cases come back again, only one was able to outwit, outplay, and outlast the competition, and that's Survivor. And it would be nothing without its host from day one, Jeff Probst.
2 days, 16 people, one survivor.
In 22 years, Jeff has done 43 seasons and over 600 episodes. But getting this once-in-a-lifetime job wasn't as easy as you think.
Today on the internet, we're looking at how Jeff Probst got his job as host on Survivor.
Before he hosted Survivor, Jeff worked on a show called Backchat on FX. At the time, the network was just getting started and Probst hosted a late-night talk show more centered around questions written in by the viewers. In a later interview, Jeff admitted at one time that no one watched the show, so no one would write in any questions, leaving Jeff and the other producers to make up stuff. Jeff would move on to host other shows like Rock and Roll Jeopardy, which, if you couldn't figure out, is a rock and roll themed spinoff of, you guessed it, The Price is Right. At the same time he was doing that, he was a correspondent for Access Hollywood, and it was around this time producers were looking to cast a different kind of host for their new show called Survivor. When Jeff heard about this, he knew it was for him. Jeff was sure he was the right choice. He was so determined to get the job, he made a mock-up Newsweek article and fake cover of the Time magazine saying Survivor was the number one show. And as crazy as this sounds, it worked. Because the producer, Mark Burnett, had done the same exact thing.
When I'd pitched CBS, I'd mocked up a Newsweek cover and a Time cover that was the number one show on television. Jeff didn't know that, but Jeff did the similar thing himself. So that was a sign to me.
And while great minds may think alike, Mark still spent the next 45 minutes convincing Jeff that he did not want this job.
I then had an interview with Jeff, and I spent 45 minutes of an hour telling him why he couldn't do this and shouldn't do this job.
He told Jeff that conditions weren't going to be what he was used to, that he would be camping out in the wilderness for upwards of a month and be exposed to all the elements that come with it. Not only would weather be terrible, but there could be all sorts of bugs, snakes, and animals out there to avoid. He laid it out to Jeff that this was not going to be an easy job. It was not going to be anything he was used to back in Hollywood. But he didn't care. He still wanted the job.
I really wanted to do something that had storytelling in it. And all the stuff I was getting offered was like dating shows where you read a prompter and say, this next couple hopes that they'll find a house. I was like, I can't do it. So I kept turning down these jobs.
He knew this was the right thing for him, but he had to wait. And did he wait? Because this wasn't a decision that the network made in a week. It wasn't even something they made in a month. This was a long process that left Jeff hanging for 4 months. 4 months he waited to hear back if he got this job. I can't wait 4 minutes for a pizza roll. Nonetheless, a job? Are you kidding me? It's unbelievable. His own job interview was its own endurance test, but it was worth the wait, because when it came down to the final two, Jeff was chosen because of a gut feeling that Mark Burnett had about him. But it's understandable why this was such a long process and why it was so hard for Mark to choose the right person, because the other person he was interviewing was Phil Kogan, and they went on to host The Amazing Race. So I think it's safe to say that Mark knows what he's talking about when he's choosing a host for his show. And boy, did he make the right choice, because as history has shown, for the last 43 seasons, this show would be nothing without Jeff Probst as its host.
It's about this entity, whatever you want to call it. It's old, it's very old. It's existed in different forms at different times. About the only thing about it that stays the same is what it lives for, really.
What is that?
Oh, the murder of innocence.
Look, this is still a script we're talking about, right, Wes?